To some extent, you're guessing with a CGI movie for many months until the shots start coming in. You have to have a lot of patience in this process. You have to trust that your instincts were right when you designed the shots.
Previz is planning for a movie shoot using computer animation to create what looks like a video game version of the film. Then all the crew gets to break it down and analyze what elements need to be done in order to produce the final product.
We decided to use Previz for AE because we realized what we were writing, we didn't have a visual. Like we have a scene and we're just supposed to shoot it without seeing, without feeling it, seeing if the emotion works and all that. So that's why we decided to bring in the Previz company, Third Floor, to help us with it.
Or a low angle, something to see.
We added that low angle or the high angle. After Earth was a unique production for the Third Floor because they approached us after filming principal photography. It was a lot of fun to watch the entire thing and then brainstorm how we could expand upon some of the more complicated sequences and the action sequences to really up the intensity of various portions of the film.
We wanted to use Previz to be able to really ensure that we had something great.
Previz is a great place to get to know who you're working with and understand what their goal is. What are they trying to achieve in this sequence? And it helps tell the story the best way possible.
We look at what's been shot already and try and find a way into the scene that's new and different, and I can actually shape the sequence and play with timing and tempo. Once we have a sequence and have something that we're happy with, then we would send those cuts to Will.
Will wanted to put together kind of his ideas for the sequence so that he could work with M. Night on various possibilities. So when I'm working on sequences, I really like to not just technically break them down, but also try to put as much emotion into them as possible. And it's my belief that if you can get an emotion in Previz, then all the better when you actually bring in the actors to do it for real. It's just going to get even better.
One of the challenging scenes in the film was where Senshi is killed by the Ursa. One of the things that we thought would help the sequence is to play a lot of Katai's reactions in the reflective glass so that we could actually see Katai's reaction to his sister and also see her in the glass both ways as the camera moved on either side of them. And it's also the reveal of the Ursa at the time is just through a hole in her body. So it's played with sound and off camera because we didn't want to give away the Ursa too soon in the movie.
Don't come out, no matter what. That's an order.
So that's one of the huge benefits of Previz. The point to use it is to make sure that whatever it is that you're doing actually works.
In the Ursa sequence, one of the things that Previz was able to help with was figuring out which direction the camera would be facing on any given shot.
As the scene between Katai and the Ursa developed, we wanted to put the cameras on opposite sides of him, but still keeping the background open so that when they set up the green screen, we could actually show a vista in the background. I think that we helped open up the fight as well as give it a little more sense of scope.
One of the things that Will was very excited about was taking a knee to convey that father-son relationship. And we were looking for a way to get that into the end fight sequence. And so we planned out the shot so that he could get hurt, and that would maybe mess up his zen. So then he remembered his father speaking to him and remembered, you know what, I need to take a knee and I need to regroup. Watching that emotion change from out of control to this zen state, it was something that Will was really excited about, the animator was really excited about, and we just had a lot of fun trying to fit that all into one shot.
That ending is fantastic now because we were able to go through every single beat, change the way Katai jumps onto the back and what weapon he does when he goes in the air. All of that Previz wouldn't have been able to do it without it.